Mr. Gentleman, yield for a question.
Dean Craddock, to yield.
He yields. Dean Craddock, if you are successful in regulating and doing away with payday loans, which is what you've been trying to do and what this will do, do you not think that this is going to push the people who are utilizing these offers and these businesses underground into gang-related activity and my buddy down here, loan sharks everywhere, Representative Craddock?
No, Mr. Stickland, I don't. Let me tell you, today we're moving more and more to online to get these loans, and they're being regulated at that level. And I think it's about time someone stood up for the small people that are being gouged. And if you look at it, if you look at the situation, Mr. Stickland, and you look at what's going on in this state, and why are the other states, you can ask Mr. Flynn, he owns one of these. He can help you with it. But yeah, we need to take care of the people in the state. And about 75% of the charities being done and the dollars being spent by charities in this state are being done to help pay these type loans off. It's wrong.
Dean Craddock, these people who are online doing stuff, they can be the dangerous ones. Yeah, and why? What happened to the notion of buyer beware?
Stickland, have you ever been in one of these places?
I have, yes, sir, and I know a lot of different people who have been in a pitch. Did you know that the last study that was done on this said that 85% of the people who utilized these loans knew exactly what the terms were, what the interest rate was, and what they were getting into? And Representative Craddock, I will make the argument here today that it is the small people who can't walk into a regular bank, who are in a pinch, who need to put food on the table, who need to make sure that their house isn't going to be taken away from them or their car. These are the people who are going to be hurt by your regulations.
Mr. Stickland,
and I just think
Mr.
it's a bad
Stickland,
idea to take
think,
away options
you,
for Texans.
If
let
you
them
think
decide,
it's right.
Not the legislature.
What? All right. Mr. Stickland, besides yelling at me, if you'd listen for a second, you might be interested to know that your numbers are wrong on this. Not 85% of the people that are going by the paying off what they can get. And most people, they keep getting rolled over and over and over again. And under the ban that the cities have done, they just say you've got to have some certain things. You can't do 20%. If I may finish, then I'll be glad to hear.
Not this time.
That for payday loans up to 20% of the borrower's gross monthly income rather than just some wild amount. And that for auto loans, either 3% of the gross annual income or 70% of the vehicle's value. This amendment limits all loans to a total of 4 payments, so you not keep rolling it over and over and charging them service fees and credit charge. It also requires 25% of the principal repayment to be done with each payment, so that you, there again, are not continuing to roll them over and over. It enhances the disclosures and informs the people of what the contract is.